beautiful Silverton. This is like a dream come true to be able to actually stay in Silverton and just be able to walk around in the morning when it's quiet. It's just the locals. Everyone's here. You know, it's a small town, and so it can feel very like intimidating to be the outsider, but everybody here is just super nice, super welcoming. Had a great night's sleep. Now we're off to explore some mines. Got my coffee from Coffee Bear, which I think still takes top spot between Coffee Bear and 81301 Roasters. They might be tied. I mean, you can't really beat this view though from Coffee Bear. Good morning from Red Mountain, Colorado. So that's actually not exactly where I'm at. I'm on the Red Mountain Pass, just north of Durango, in between Durango and Ouray, or Ouray, remember, I don't know how to say it. This is one of my favorite places in the entire world. I'm somewhat of a mining history buff. I think this is amazing that these pieces of history are still here for us to explore. It's a testament to the people who founded this country, who put in all this hard work. I mean, we're in the middle of a mountain pass, and there were buildings, like my tripods on this building. They earned a living in the most rugged of ways. And I mean, even just looking at all the nails that were handmade, and I am just in awe. So we are here. We've actually seen this mine before, but I always like coming back because nature kind of starts to erode, and sometimes new things are found, other times things that you've loved are gone. And so I like to come back every year that I'm here. A little bit later on, we're going to be going to a very special spot where my original adventure dog, Chunka, had her very last adventure, and some of her ashes are spread up there. I feel her here. I can see her little fluffy tail in the air. I lost her 1 month after visiting here. So this is a really special spot. But today, on a good, happy note, there's actually an additional mine that I have time to go explore. So I'm actually gonna do it via foot. This is a four-wheel drive road. It's pretty rutted out. I bottomed out coming up this far. So we just are gonna keep parked here, and we're just gonna explore on foot. It's about 3 mile total trek to get to the mines that I haven't seen. So today is just all about exploring history, taking it in. It's just such a unique feeling in these old ghost towns, these old mine towns, because people just left. So you can find cups and plates and dolls and pieces of people's lives because they just left. And it's just such a cool, I'm rambling here, but this is just such a cool spot, and I hope you enjoy getting to visit it with me. I feel very blessed that this is my third time here, and I'm still finding new things. And things have changed, and things are different because it's a different time of year. So anyways, we're going to get to exploring. We're going to finish off this mine. We're going to head to Yankee Girl Mine. I believe it's Yankee Girl Mine. It's really hard to figure out locations here, but I know there's a sign on the next one. So we're going to head to the next mine, and then after that, it's a brand new to me mine, so we will take you along as well. So we'll see you then. So since I've been here, they actually put this little road in. Used to like shimmy shake down the shale to get to where we just were. There's a chute up here. So the mine shaft is on the other side. We're gonna go see. They must have chuted it maybe down to the little town. I don't know. That's what I love, like just kind of mentally putting it together. And even if it's wrong, it's still enjoyable. So if you know, tell me, because I would love to know.
River's gonna cry when you're gone.
that is the mine shaft behind me. Super creepy because there's a raft there. So I have a feeling with how high that water level is, somebody went on an adventure, which is creeptastic to me. I feel like the dude from Ghost Town Living would totally do that. Not on my list to do today. So this is the first mine. So one more chute down here we'll walk to, and we're gonna head to the next one. Waiting for your call. Seems like time as a wave passing by, leave a mark in our minds to turn to memories. The river's gonna cry when you're gone, 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 gone. The river's gonna cry when you're gone, 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 gone. The river's gonna cry when you're gone, gone. River's gonna cry when you're. River's gonna cry when you're. River's gonna cry when you're gone. Hey, I was hoping you would stay, but I've always known that you would go find your own way. Well, look at that. I was correct. This is the Yankee Girl Mine. So yesterday I said iron ore. This was actually silver and gold. It's a vertical shaft, goes straight down and all the way up. Had a hoist house. I'm just reading the sign. I'm not that smart. And it's got a hell of a view. That's work with a view. Watch the river run, and the sun would always shine. When we sat there, you and I. The construction of this is just mind-boggling to me. This is probably four stories, and it just has four different sets, five sets of different planks going straight up. There's windows up there, all handmade nails. How they got it up here, like, my Jeep couldn't make it up here, so they were on mules, I'm assuming. I know there's a train station up there we're gonna go see a little bit later, but I don't think there was one to here. Maybe there was, I have to read up. But we're like, that's the mountain pass, then it goes deep down in and then back up. So it just, I'm always awestruck by just the sheer grit these people had to build this stuff and to do this work. And I bitch about sitting at my laptop for 8 hours a day. Yankee Girl is pretty iconic actually, because that is Highway 55, Million Dollar Highway, mountain pass. It goes from Durango to Ouray. And you can see it, there's actually an overlook right up there. So you can see it. It's actually what got me back here the first time. I didn't know any of this was back here, but I Google Earth to figure out how I could get to that. And then we found everything else. So if you're ever traveling north or south down 550, get to Red Mountain Pass, see an overlook, look this way. And that is the Yankee Girl Mine. Gone, gone. The river's gonna cry when you're gone, 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 gone. The river's gonna cry when you're. The river's gonna cry when you're. Gonna cry when you're gone. Hey, I was hoping you would stay, but I've always known that you would go find your own way. I still see when we climbed up in those trees, 12 years old, feel the wind. Watch the river run, and the sun would always shine. When we sat there, you and I. The river's gonna cry when you're gone, 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 gone. The river's gonna cry when you're gone, 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 gone. The river's gonna cry when you're gone, 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 gone. The river's gonna cry when you're. It's gonna cry when you're gone. It's gonna cry, it's gonna cry.
this old town, just leave it all behind. The river's gonna cry when you're gone.
This ghost town is crazy. There had to have been at least 30 buildings right in this spot, just from like the foundations and the various cabins that I've saw. The track used to go from here across, over and up. Definitely the biggest remaining ghost town mine that I've seen. There's one more building down there. I'll admit, I was feeling a little creeped out. Just lots of wildlife noises. So another Jeep came up here and made some noise, and now I feel better. But I was definitely feeling the ghost town vibes. You know, had the bear spray out, like ready to go. I was gonna like do this real quick, but he made a lot of noise, so we feel better now. But yeah, it's just crazy to me. I mean, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Like right here alone are 10 buildings. And there's just remnants. So probably a good 30 here. So this must have been a really big town. Probably Red Mountain Town. So Red Mountain Town and Red Mountain City were right across the highway from each other. I believe Red City Town was the more prosperous. And this would make sense because this is a massive operation. So cool. I'm so glad I hoped and poked my way up here. I don't know if I'm crazy, but I've decided to drop down a little further. So when I was up at Yankee Girl looking down, I saw more stuff that I really want to go see. It's quite a bit of a drop, so I'm probably going to hate myself on the way back up, but all for the adventure, baby. All for the adventure. Okay, I lied. The little offshoot just brought you around. I actually don't know how to get down there because I just came that way and there were no other paths that went down. So I have a feeling it's one of those ones that snakes a ways through. So I don't think I'm going to make it down there today because it's probably a good 800 feet down there. So I can't shimmy shale. Yeah. I'm not shimmy shaling that. I about died doing it the other day, so. Not hitting that today. So back to Yankee Girl Mine. We're gonna head back to where the Jeep is. Then we're gonna head up to Gaston, which is a little ghost town, which is where my Chunka Girl is. Thank you. We made it up to Guston. I called it Guston, Disney baby, Beauty and the Beast. Guston, believe it or not, is a railroad depot. What makes it so important that this structure that I showed you that is behind me was the only passenger shelter. So it made this particular depot incredibly important. This was built in 1887 to 1889, ran to 1893. Apparently, this whole area was unrecognizable by 1926. It's completely gone. But in 2014, volunteers came back up and they pulled some of the original pieces, repurchased some of the original pieces that the owner had, and repurposed this little memorial of the Guston station. And I use the word memorial kind of tongue in cheek. And I want to share a really special story with you. So Chunka was my original adventure dog. And in about 2 years ago, she was just getting ready to turn, almost 3 years ago, I guess, she's just getting ready to turn 11 or 12. And my brother and I had a 6-day Colorado backcountry camping trip planned for September. And I was really worried about taking her and about it just being too much for her. And I was just waffling back and forth. I called my vet who I trust and I said, what should I do? And she said, Michelle, you should take her and you should enjoy the shit out of her. And so I did. And so we were staying in Telluride, and what I did is I found a great Rover sitter for two of the days. So that way it kind of was like every other day, she had the ability to just rest all day in a nice warm house. And so on those days we hiked, and then on the days I had her, my brother would go do something and I'd hang with the dogs. So the last day we were here, we wanted to do this mining town, and I had every intention. I had brought her bed, I put it in the shade by the Jeep. I was just gonna stay where I could see her, but my brother started climbing up this mountain to Guston, and she just put her little fluffy tail up in the air and followed him. And so I just kind of giggled and I was like, all right, I'm just gonna follow her to, you know, wherever she lays down, I stop. And that girl made it all the way up here, which it's 11,200 feet right here. It's no joke. And she just plopped her little keister right on this platform. And my brother and I went just a little further. There's just one more building down there, and came back and I popped open a Coke and just chilled with her. And I still feel her here. It's actually weird because I don't feel her as much in Arizona, where she lived, as I do here. I can literally picture her fluffy tail coming up this mountain. I feel her here. So every year I come back, I pop open a Coke and I hang out with her for a little bit. The year after she passed, I did come up and I spread her ashes in a special spot. They're not right here. I wanted somewhere special just for me that other people weren't going to trample. Not that they'd trample her, but you know what I mean. And so every year I come up here and I say hi to my adventure girl. And if I could give you one piece of advice, if you have an elderly dog, modify, take your adventures with your elderly dog. Those last trips were, they are so special to me. She passed away exactly 4 weeks later, very comfortably. And looking at the pictures and the videos from this trip healed my heart, because I knew I gave her an amazing life. And I knew that she was healthy enough to do something like this. I took care of her. So I'm going to stop blubbering. I just wanted to share that with you because I think it's easy to look, you know, I have a young, healthy dog. But I've had an elderly dog too, that I adventured and I modified and I did what I could. And I'm so grateful for those moments. And I'm so grateful for this place and this memory. And that's my favorite memory of her.